Market day in Baku, a world away from the modern cosmopolitan seafront set to host the European Games. It's not a normal stop on the escorted media tours of Azerbaijan's capital city, but one we were allowed to make as long as we didn't try and talk to anyone. We were there to talk about a sporting event after all.
From 10 medals, their best ever Olympic haul at London 2012, there's a real push for more, particularly in the traditional sports like wrestling.
It's often referred to as the national sport of Azerbaijan, with their wrestlers some of the best in the world. Ravshan Bayramov is one of his country's biggest stars, a former European and world champion and two-time Olympic silver medalist.
Of course, it will be a great celebration for Azerbaijan and a great test of every athlete. Because the first European Games are being held in Azerbaijan, it will be a very respected tournament for us. We will do our very best to get the highest results and to show Europe and the entire world what Azerbaijan's athletes are capable of.
The critics say that Azerbaijan is simply leading the charge for international sports events without truly investing in their athletes.
We have 66% of the population of our country, young people under 35 years old. And a lot of them involved in the sport. We pay, as a government, big attention to the sport construction, for the involving young people, for the hosting different big sport events. And of course, we want to see our future generation healthy, and the sport is the best opportunity and possibility to get that.
I've seen the investments that are going on away from Baku in sports facilities, in infrastructure around the whole of the country. So this is not just about showcasing, this is not just the tip of the iceberg. There is a considerable amount of work that is being done below the waterline to really promote Azerbaijan through sport.
How worried are you that you wrestlers might not be the stars anymore?
I'm just happy our other sports are improving as much as wrestling. It would be nice if there were more stars in Azerbaijan.
It's difficult not to be impressed at the investment in facilities and athletes in Baku. The National Gymnastics Centre opened in April 2014 with the country's top gymnasts sleeping, eating, going to school and training on site. Rhythmic gymnast Marina Durunda is one of Azerbaijan's best hopes of a medal at the European Games. She's a two-time national champion who's previously represented Ukraine and trained in Cyprus.
Gymnastics in Azerbaijan is moving very rapidly forward, and the facilities are getting better and better for training, for competing here. And the Azerbaijan Gymnastics Federation is doing so much for their athletes, and it cannot be compared with any other country.
She's already been given a house by the president for her contribution to sport in Azerbaijan, but these facilities really are attracting the attention of the world. Some of the New Zealand team were there during our visit.
The facilities here, all the floors and the equipment and the height of the ceiling, because at home we train in a school hall and the ceiling's really low, and we only get to train sort of 4 hours a day, whereas here, most of them live here, which is crazy, and they'll train 4 hours in the morning and then have like 3 or 4 hours off and then train another 4 hours, so yeah. And they have constant ballet, and they have like the physio and doctors here, so yeah, it's incredible.
Do you think we'll ever see anything like this in New Zealand?
No, unless it's got anything to do with rugby, then no.
The European Games will be a chance for athletes from Azerbaijan to pit themselves against some of the world's best. The government won't admit to a medal target, but those involved have no doubt about the importance of their moment.
My first goal is the European Games, then World Championship, and then the next one is the Olympics, if God wills, I hope.
What would it mean to you to hear the Azerbaijan national anthem, the flag going up, and a gold medal being put around your neck? at the European Games here in Baku.
It's every athlete's dream. We all want to see our country's flag rising up.
Azeri athletes celebrate at their final warm-up events. They'll be hoping for more of the same when the competition starts for real.